in single stop matching. So the matching in the transmission line problems means simply terminating the line in its characteristic impedance. Okay. So why we need? So it is required because in transmission line network, the standing waves, which are the generated waves because of reflected wave, and this happens because the load impedance is not properly matched with the characteristic impedance. This leads to increase the losses, and because of that, the power transmission is also affected. So that's why one of the technique is single stub matching is used for reducing these standing waves and making the power transmission properly. So you can see this is the transmission line with ZL is 200 plus JF 100 ohm, and characteristic impedance of the transmission line is 100 ohm. We have to place this stub on this transmission line at distance D from the load, and the length of the stub LS is such that it matches the ZL with the characteristic impedance. So the junction 11 dash is the point where the stub is to be placed, and Y11 dash, which represents the total admittance of the line and stub. Here the stub must be located on the line where the real part of the admittance, if we look towards the load, then it should be Y0, means characteristic admittance. Line of the stub we have to adjust in such a way that the stub's acceptance cancels out the line's acceptance. So consider this, we will solve this numerical with the help of Smith chart. Here we have to, first step is to find out normalized Z impedance, small ZL, normalized value we will represent with small z, which is capital Z divided by Z naught. So 200 plus J 100 divided by 100, we will get 2 plus J 1, which is the normalized load impedance. Second value, we will find out normalized YL on the point on the Smith chart. So let us plot. This is the center of the chart. Two, the real part is 2 and 1 is the imaginary part. So we will plot 2 plus J1. This is our ZL, normalized load impedance. To find out the normalized admittance, we will draw SWR circle. For that, we have to keep the radius. From the center to ZL. Then we have to plot exactly 180 degree phase shifting from the ZL, and we will receive this point. This will represent YL. The value of YL, if we will see the circle, then it is 0.4, the real constant R circle, and imaginary part is 0.2. So we can note down the value of YL. Third step, find out the single stub matching. Let us note down it. 0.4 plus J 0.2. After finding the YL, we have to move on this SWR circle. This is our SWR circle, and we have to move on this SWR circle in clockwise direction, and we have to find out the intersection of this SWR circle with unity circle. The unity circle is represented by this 1. R is equal to 1 circle, and here is the intersection. So mark this point with YD. This is the line impedance from where we have to connect the stub. Okay, so this point will give us the distance D where we have to place the short circuited stub. So how to find the distance? Let's calculate. So again, mark the point, connect the line from center to YL, and mark the point at the end of this Smith chart or outermost circle, and measure the wavelength which is marked. It is 0.464 lambda. Okay. Similarly, for point YD, using the from the center of the chart and through YD point, we have to mark the second point at the outermost circle of the Smith chart, and note down the distance which is marked. That is 0.16162. It is 0.162 lambda. So this distance up to this distance represents the distance D from load towards the generator. So we have to calculate the length clockwise, because we have to calculate the length from load towards generator. So if we'll see, the distance is 0.5 up to this. So first of all, we have to calculate this distance. Okay. Then we will add this distance with 0.162. It starts again from zero here. Okay. So we will write it third step, plot YD by rotating the SWR circle by moving on SWR circle clockwise and intersecting point with unity circle. So that is point YD. That is the line admittance. The next step is to calculate the distance D, which is the distance between point YL and point load YD. So we have calculated that distance. So first of all, we have to calculate 0.5 minus 0.464 lambda. Then we will add this distance with 0.162 lambda. Okay. So B is 0.038 plus 0.162. It is 0.2 lambda. So at 0.2 lambda from the load towards the generator, we have to place our short circuited stub. Next we want to find out the length of the stub. What should be the length of the stub? For that, as you can see, it is unity, so the value of the YD is 1, and the point is on upper half of the circle, so 1 plus the negative part is positive, 1 plus j, and it is mentioned by 1, 1 plus j1. So point YD is 1 plus j1. As you can see, the susceptance given by YD is plus j1. If our stub will add the negative susceptance, then and then this wide line impedance will become 1. So we have to adjust the length of the stub such that its susceptance is minus J1. So we have to find out minus J1 on this line, and it is given by this point, minus J1. So we have to consider the center to this minus J1 point, and we have to mark the distance by calculating this outermost circle length, and it is 0.375 lambda. Now, as we are working on the admittance, so for admittance, this point is considered as short circuited point, and this point is considered as open circuited point. So as we are connecting the short circuited stub, we have to calculate the distance from the short circuited end clockwise up to this point. So the length of the stub can be identified or can be calculated using 0.375 minus 0.25 lambda. So length of the stub is 0.375 minus 0.25 lambda, which will give us 0.125 lambda. So we can say the length of the stub should be 0.125 lambda. If we have the frequency or wavelength given for the particular transmission line, then we can find out the distance, okay, where the stub is to be placed, and the length of the stub in that particular unit, meter or centimeter or whatever. So this is how we can solve the transmission line using the single stub matching technique. After placing this stub, there will be no standing waves or reflected waves generated on the left side from the stub towards the generator.